be very difficult for most Americans even to comprehend.
And it is now being exported at record rates with the political left worshiping it, and the ultimate sin is criticizing radical Islam. What is the insane equation there where places like France are xenophobic against other European cultures and language, but are importing radical Islam as fast as they can?
Well, even in the United States, I mean, the surprising thing is that the, for instance, on the left, the feminist movement does not oppose radical Islam, even though it's, you know, violently discriminates against women, abuses women, and it does so on a, as a theological, on a theological basis. Yet the American left embraces Islam and ignores all of these atrocities that Islam creates. So you've got a love affair with the left worldwide, and you see it in France, you see it in the European countries. We're also importing a large number of Muslims into the United States with the Obama administration. That's, again, not being actively reported. We're reporting it at WND. You're reporting it at InfoWars. But in general, the influx of Muslims under the Obama administration and in high policy positions, Muslim Brotherhood in high policy positions in the State Department and the administration throughout has not been adequately covered.
Well, sure, and everybody knows that I was against these previous wars, and I'm not a, quote, Islamophobe. But, I mean, I went to high school and college with really nice Muslim folks that weren't radical. Some of these earlier waves were really, you know, scientists, engineers, really doctors, neat people. The folks coming in now, and I live in Austin, Texas, are Wahhabists. I mean, I talk to them, I see them, I hear them. I see them, like, shoving their wife down the street, wearing a hood over her head, bugging their eyes out at me. I mean, it's getting pretty creepy, and, I mean, I don't want to live in Saudi Arabia. I'm sorry.
Well, the responsible position should be to support moderate forces within Islam to have a reformation, and they can be found. I mean, al-Sisi in Egypt, for instance, is one of the moderate forces in Islam that could help to get a re-evaluation of the violent nature of radical Islamic terrorism. I mean, what, you know, I think any responsible person is opposed to radical Islamic terrorism rather than Islam itself. We're not going to go to war with a billion people in the world who believe in Islam, most of whom don't want any of this violence at all.
Absolutely. And you know, Bill Maher says they all want violence, or most of them. No, that's not true. But the groups taking over do. And I want to talk about that radicalization when we come back with Dr. Jerome Corsi of WND.com. I'm Alex Jones. I was just thinking during the break, Alex Jones here back live, how sick the so-called left really are. How they would try to end fatherhood and manhood and try to ban dodgeball or even running in the playgrounds because it's seen as aggressive. They just want to enslave us. And now they say all sex is rape, and then they'll never criticize sexual mutilation, radical Islam. And they put movies out with David Cross where they go, Alex Jones is a racist Islamophobe, just randomly in the movie. When I was criticized for being against the Iraq war and all the rest of it, doesn't mean I want to be colonized by radical Islam. Which, if you hadn't looked around, has taken over. Even the UN says Christians are being persecuted at record levels. Why are Christians so low in the government's eye? Why can't Christians get bakeries to put Christian verses on cakes, but the, quote, gays and lesbians can? Because Christianity is seen as the dominant culture, and we're being conquered right now. That's my view. Dr. Corsi is a sociologist, anthropologist, political scientist, well-traveled man. Why is there a major war on Christianity, or do you disagree that there's not one? I mean, look at Lois Lerner not getting in trouble.
Well, I think you see it. You've identified it correctly. There is a war on Christianity going on. The left agenda, the agenda of the left, sees an opportunity right now to get, as it were, a final victory in terms of the culture war, pressing on the LGBT agenda, have, you know, various forms of sexual preference be declared a constitutional right, so that, you know, what happens to the First Amendment? Well, if you object to this, you are a bigot. Churches, we're going to see lawsuits increasingly to tax churches that do not support the LGBT agenda. Around the world, and the Pope has mentioned this as well, you're seeing Christians under attack on throughout the Middle East, throughout Africa, slaughters of Christians, which are being largely unreported and largely not even taken seriously. The UN, which has largely been, you know, again, very supportive of a radical Islamic agenda, had from the beginning of the Palestinian debate going back, you know, 30 or 40 years, The UN has not speaking up for Christians the way it would be expected to speak up for Islam.
And that's because Christians are politically incorrect. Christians need to just roll over and die or become Marxist conduits or we will be destroyed.
The choice are, you know, first, what's acceptable politically is you can be an atheist or you can be, you know, certainly Islam is not being criticized by the left, but any true Christianity is viewed as being portrayed as bigoted, being, you know, portrayed as out of touch with reality.
Well, Christianity is what caused basically the modern Renaissance and inclusiveness and the Reformation, as you were getting at. And it's just, I mean, they've taken the fruits of that and are now bringing in a totalitarianism. In closing, what do you make separately?
We've been through this before with the ancient Roman Empire. I mean, ancient Roman Empire had, you know, Christianity was the solution to the violence, the paganism, and the, you know, the anything goes kind of attitude, value relativism, that it produced the chaos of the ancient world. And Christianity largely brought the ancient world into a reformation, the Enlightenment, and the modern world. Now we're going the opposite direction. We're going back to moral relativism. We're saying that any attitudes people have, regardless of, you know, what they want to believe or not believe, or have sexually or not have sexually, is within their preference, and they're all constitutionally protected, except if you want to believe in Jesus Christ and profess Christianity.
I was about to say there's that paradox where anything goes except if we say it doesn't, and then it's totalitarianism.
The left is not going to be tolerant. It's not going to be classically liberal. It doesn't believe in a First Amendment. It believes that if you don't adhere to the left's principles, you need to go to thought reform because you are not only incorrect, you're evil, you've got to be crushed, you've got to be abused.
You are watching the best of the Alex Jones Show, weekdays from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. Watch live at InfoWars.com/show or become a member of InfoWarsNews.com and help us take resistance to the next level.